So in today's video, we're going to talk about these transformers right here. Now this is a so-called neon sign transformer, or NST for short. They have quite a high output voltage compared to other transformers like MOTs, for example. This one here has an output voltage of about 12,000 volt at a current of 30 milliamps. They come in other voltages though, mainly between 3 and 15,000 volts with currents up to 60 milliamps. These transformers are quite useful for the high voltage hobbyist since they're current limited, which means that you can arc them as long as you want and they won't burn out. Due to the fact that they have current limiting shunts in them, they will definitely last more than 5 minutes, as photonic induction would say. Unlike these things. Now these are nasty little bastards, because this tiny transformer will definitely kill you. Now this is your standard regular sized MOT. It looks a lot smaller compared to the NST, but it's a lot more dangerous. I mean, if you were to touch one of the outputs from the NST, you would probably get a horrible shock that you definitely remember, but you probably wouldn't die. Although, if you were to touch both ends of the transformer at the same time, then it could also be fatal, so still be very careful with your NSTs. So, on most transformers, if not all of them, you're gonna have a label like this. It is gonna tell you all of the main important parameters of your transformer. Mainly the input voltage, which in my case, since I live in Europe, is 277 volts, which is a bit higher than my mains voltage here, which is 230 volts, but I can adjust for that with my variac supply. Then the frequency, which in this case is 60 Hz, also a bit off considering that here in Europe we have 50 Hz, but doesn't really matter. And then we have the current consumption, which also doesn't really matter. Then we have the secondary voltage, which this is the voltage between both high voltage terminals. The voltage between one of the high voltage terminals to chassis ground is going to be half of that. And then the output current, in this case 30 milliamps. And those are basically all the key important details you want to know about your transformer. So it's actually quite simple to wire one of these transformers up. You have your chassis ground here, basically a screw that is connected to the case of the transformer. That's your ground. It is very important that you connect that one, otherwise you might have some voltages on the case. I will explain later why that is. Then, usually on a small bushing like this one, you have your mains input terminals, and then there are usually one or two big bushings. In this case we have one here and one on the other side over here. Those are your two high voltage terminals. And in the case of this transformer, which puts out 12,000 volt at 30 milliamps, you get 6,000 volt from this thing to case and 6,000 volt from this thing to case. And between the two, we have 12,000 volts. I will explain later why that is. And in this case, this is a special transformer because it has a secondary ground fault protection in it. Basically, some kind of GFCI, but for the high voltage output. Which means that if there's a current flow from one of these terminals to ground, this transformer shuts off. You can bypass that by pushing this button though. So now let me tell you how these transformers look on the insides. And for that, we gotta bring out the paper of knowledge. So if we take a look at the schematic here, we can see that we don't actually get the 12,000 volt transformers. So it's a scam, right? Actually, no. We get two 6,000 volt transformers that are faced as such that between the two outer ends of the secondaries on the transformers, we get 12,000 volt, since they're phase shifted. Now, the red line is the sinusoidal output from, let's say, this side of this transformer, and the green line here is the output from this side of this transformer right here. And we can see they're phase shifted by 180 degrees. So if this output is at plus 6000 volts, then the other output, this one here, is gonna be at minus 6000 volts. And between the two, we get 12,000 volts. And then the middle point of the two transformers is grounded. And this is why it is really important that you connect the ground. Because if you wouldn't connect the ground here, then you might get some voltage on the case. For example, if you were to ground this end of the transformer, then the case would be live at about 6,000 volts to ground. And you don't want that. That could cause some internal damage to the transformer, which is basically unrepairable since the entire thing is potted in some kind of tar or resin. And so it's really, really hard to repair these things. So be careful with them. Now, a last thing before I go, and this is really important, and that is that you should never ever pick up any kind of high voltage equipment by its insulators. And this is also true for this neon sign transformer. Never pick it up by its insulators. Picking up your transformer by the bushings will cause them to snap off and destroy your transformer and possibly injure you, since the transformer is really heavy. Also, you would be grabbing the transformer by its outputs, which if the transformer would be live, that could give you a deadly shock. So don't do that. Always pick it up at the bottom as shown in the picture. So now to everyone's favorite part, and that is arcing the transformer. Now, let's draw some arcs without any salts or anything on the electrode. I hope you enjoy. So now, as we usually do, let's draw some arcs through some baking soda and see how it affects the output. Now, in this case, I've been wearing some Shade 5 brazing goggles, which is kind of overkill, but it looks cool and better be safe than sorry, right? So these are definitely not the longest arcs I've ever made on this channel, but I still hope that you enjoyed it and maybe learned something. But yeah, until next time, stay safe and keep exploring science. This was Science by Sergio, and I'm out. Goodbye.